Namaste everybody once again. My name is Kumar Sambhav and I am also exploring into the content of right understanding and right living. And I'm also able to see some transformation that has taken place in me. And I'm working for further transformation in me. In that process, I'm trying to understand the values as well as share with my relatives. And I can see that every human being is related to me. And we got a good opportunity some time back to have online workshops for faculty in technical education. And that has somewhat opened a new channel for us to be related. In fact, I might not have seen most of us in this session, but we all feel related because we are trying to work for right understanding in each one of them, in each one of us. And that is the platform with which I would like to share something from my side. So we have been conducting sessions every Sunday morning where one of us has been sharing the content of right understanding, and we have been giving out feedback about the sharing. And there are certain things to be taken care of while sharing the values. Now this is just a kind of preparation to take us forward. We all are gearing up to conduct the sessions online, and there's so much of work ahead. ICT has been active for the past 3 years. Now gradually other institutions also are gearing up. So we need to prepare ourselves. So on one hand, we have to ensure a transformation in our understanding, in our living. On the other hand, we are participating for transforming the society around. So it is a part of that process only. And it is one of the processes, it is one of the channels taking the message forward. So at the background, we have gone through this content. So what is the expectation from education sanskar, something which we all are a part of? So education is developing right understanding, and sanskar is the commitment, preparation, and practice for right living. And preparation includes learning the right skills and technology also. Development of the competence to live with definite human conduct is something which is required through education so that the student can move from discipline to self-discipline. And that necessitates three things. One is right understanding, that is wisdom or clarity about what to do as a human being in oneself, in family, in society, in nature. In the right feeling, that is the capacity to live in relationship with other human beings in family, society, etc. And then the right skills for prosperity, that is the capacity to identify the need for physical facility, the skills and practice for sustainable production of more than what is required, and the feeling of prosperity. So this is something that we all are acquainted with. I will not elaborate on this, but this is something which forms the background. So we also have to see whether we are able to see this clearly or not. Now, if you look at the natural process of human education sanskar, so when the environment is conducive, then we have this process for a child, that the child starts like imitating and then following, and then is obedient to the parents or the guardians in the family, then enters into a state of discipline. And then through that, through self-verification, is able to enter into a state of self-discipline. And then emerges with self-confidence. And when he or she becomes a parent, then it goes to the next generation in a similar manner. And this happens in an environment of relationship. But on the other hand, when the environment is not conducive, then the same process of imitating, following, being, going by discipline may lead to all these like arbitrariness, opposition, revolt, struggle, war, and then the environment of domination. And certainly something which is written on the right-hand side is not desirable. What is written on the left-hand side is desirable. And we can reflect on our own living, whether we have been able to ensure something which is written on the left-hand side. If not, then can we plan something which is written on the left-hand side for the next generation? Okay. Now, if you look at the... If you look at the whole process of sharing on the basis of feeling of relationship, then as a student, what is to be observed? So the student wants to be happy and make other happy. So intention wise, the student is sound. Whatever be the level of competence of the student, this intention part has to be clear to me as a teacher. And for this, there is a need to understand he wants or she wants to understand and is an explorer. The student has acceptance for the teacher. Now this is desirable that the student has acceptance for the teacher, even if not there. So I have to work on myself so that the student develops acceptance for me. The student is able to see that the teacher is more competent, is making effort for excellence. The student is able to see that the teacher is fulfilled within. Now, if you see, ultimately, when we are expecting something from the student, then we have to be observant that the student is also expecting certain things from me. So we might be expecting too many things from the student, but we might not be observant of what the student is expecting from me. So this is something to be noted on our side. If the teacher is seen as being unfulfilled, unhappy, etc., the student may not be able to accept the teacher. I'll share one thing that generally, while teaching the course on human values, I have observed one thing that there would be at least 20% students who are curious to understand, who would like to pay attention, would like to sit in the front, ask questions, try to relate to the content. There will be 20% students who are quite reluctant. This is a general observation that I have found. Who are quite reluctant, would like to take the back seat, talk during the class or start operating the mobile or something. And there are 60% students who take sides. They may be on the first side or the second side, depending upon the environment in the class. But one thing to observe is that those 20% who are reluctant to understand, they are also observing you. And many times I have found that after the session is over, the semester is over, and when they meet you, they might meet from some other department, they will come to you and say that, sir, we tried to disturb you so much in the class, but you never got perturbed. This is something that I have noted. Now, you might not be aware of this kind of thing which is there on the part of the students, but the students are observing you. And that becomes a takeaway for the whole life, isn't it? I'll also share one thing here as an incident that I was teaching at a university sometime back, and we did not have this formal course. That was about 15 years back. We did not have a formal course in the university, but I just conducted a session for 2 hours. And in that session, we just talked about right understanding relationship and physical facility, the priority for that. And after some time, like when I had left teaching in that university, and that was about 6 to 7 years back. So I was going from Delhi to Kanpur and I was boarding a bus. Then one person came and started chatting with me. And then I learned that he was a student of that batch in which I had conducted the session. And he said that, sir, we could not follow the whole thing that was shared in those 2 hours. But I just remembered that one formulation was given, that there is something called SBD square, there is something called SC square, there is something called S power 4. So SBD square is Suvidha Vihin Dukhi Daridr, S square is Suvidha Sampanna Dukhi Daridr, and S power 4 is Suvidha Sampanna Sukhi Samvid. And he told me that he decided on that very day that he does not have to be S square D square. Now, these are certain things which can be taken away by the student, which we might not be aware of. So when we are conducting a course, okay, we can also feel that not every student may be paying attention the same way, but they may be taking away certain things from the content, from your conduct. Now, as a teacher, what is expected? So I have to be clear that the student wants to understand, can understand, and I need to have a feeling of trust. Has a feeling of responsibility to guide the student. I have a feeling of guidance in me. Then the teacher has definite conduct, working for excellence, or has become excellent. And at the same time, he's a co-explorer. This is something that we do have to ensure that we all are co-explorers. We have not reached presently the state of completeness of right understanding, and we are exploring the process. Some person may be ahead, some person may be lagging behind. But when we talk about the feeling of trust, we are able to see that competence is lacking or maybe lacking on the part of teacher as well as the student as well as any other person. And we have to be complementary. So to be complementary, I have to be a co-explorer. I have to keep the content of right understanding at the core and then share my understanding or my feeling about that particular thing. The teacher's satisfaction or state of happiness should be visible in the enthusiasm, eagerness, clarity. This is something that we have to observe about ourselves as a teacher. So as a co-explorer, what can be seen? So I came across this content, found it meaningful. I understood something and I'm exploring something. So, हम सभी co-explorer हैं, यानी जांचने परखने की प्रक्रिया में शामिल हैं. और हमने कुछ चीजों को समझा है और कुछ चीजों को समझने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं. And this sharing or even teaching the course is a natural outcome of feeling of responsibility. जो भी ये शेयरिंग कर रहे हैं, चाहे वर्कशॉप में या फिर क्लासरूम में, ये उसका एक natural outcome. In fact, when you look at the process of self-exploration, and then when you go to validate the proposal, then while ensuring or validating whether it is leading to mutual happiness or not, sharing is also required. I may share it formally in a workshop, or I may share it informally in my relationship. So sharing is a natural outcome hai, aur ek zimmedari ke bhav ke saath ye hota hi hai. And we all are co-explorers. Hum sabhi saath saath samajhne mein lage hue hain. The participants will get connected when they see you as a happy, stable, or consistent person rather than a preacher. So we are not preachers. Hum koi updesh dene ke liye nahi aaye hain, koi updeshak nahi hain. Parantu हमें दिख गया है कि हम सुखी होना चाहते हैं, समृद्ध होना चाहते हैं, और सुखी समृद्ध होने के लिए मुझे कम से कम अपने आप में दिखता है कि यही विधि है. परंतु जब मैं दूसरे के साथ शेयर करता हूं, तो कोई जरूरी नहीं कि मैं कहूं कि यही विधि है, हमारे लिए यह भी विधि है, है ना, ये हम संबंध में कह सकते हैं. बट अपने अंदर ये दिखना जरूरी है कि यही विधि है. राइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड राइट फीलिंग के द्वारा ही हमारे में निरंतर सुख हो सकता है. तो उससे हमारे अंदर एक स्टेबिलिटी आती है, कंसिस्टेंसी आती है. This is something which is observed by the other. So it may be the case, just as an example, that we are talking about complementarity in the workshop, but one may rejoice competition momentarily in our living. Now the other is observing you that during the workshop or during in the classroom you are talking about complementarity, and now you are rejoicing competition. Okay. So this is something which is observed by the other person. So we have to be observant about ourselves also as a co-explorer. Now, while sharing the content, one have to observe one's feeling. And this is something which is to be observed every moment. Then one has to be clear that the other wants to understand, can understand. Maybe having difficulty grasping the content, or you may be having difficulty explaining it. So seldom are we able to see that I am having difficulty explaining. Most of the time we feel that the other is having difficulty grasping. हमें कई बार ये लगता है कि अगला समझना नहीं चाहता या ये समझ नहीं सकता. But हम ये कई बार नहीं देख पाते कि मैं समझा नहीं पा रहा. अगर हमें ये दिख जाए कि मैं समझा नहीं पा रहा, तो हर बार हम इस बात के लिए प्रयास करेंगे कि कैसे और बेहतर ढंग से बात को रख सकूं कि अगला व्यक्ति समझ जाए. Let me share that the way this whole content has evolved. Okay. You see, it has been an outcome of this particular thing that if the other is not able to understand, I have to evolve the content, the presentation, the way of sharing so that the other is able to understand. So the same way I have to look at myself, that if the other is having difficulty in grasping, then I have to see whether I can make my sharing better so that I can explain better, the other is able to understand in a better way. And your enthusiasm and liveliness, in fact happiness reflects as your liveliness. We may be talking a lot of things, but if that liveliness is not there, okay, some gloomy kind of expression is there or something like that, so the other does not feel motivated, then the other person takes it as a kind of theory being shared in the class. But that will come gradually, that will not come in a day or two. So if you observe, you find that if I am happy within, that liveliness will exhibit in my conduct, in my face, in my expression, in my behavior, the way I work. And if I'm able to see very clearly that everybody wants to understand and can understand, I will always feel enthused. I will never feel, you know, like depressed or something. Now, the common mistakes in conducting the session is like we enter into preaching. So that is not desirable. We preach. This is not a preaching course. Or we start imposing. This is it. And you have to accept it. This will not work. Then we may also try to dominate. Now you see that while conducting the course in a classroom, there may be some students who are not ready to listen. And then the teacher may start dominating, even in the workshop. Now, the participants are observing your conduct at that particular moment also. If you got infuriated, if you started dominating, then even though they had been accepting your words earlier, they may start negating, or they may start, you know, or they may stop accepting you as a resource person there. There is something to be observed. Then passing judgment. There is no need to pass judgment. Trying to get feeling of praise from the other. Now, if the other starts accepting the content or our expression, then sometimes it may be the case that we start working for getting more and more goody-goody words from the other, praise from the other. Then another mistake could be like we present very formally. कई बार ऐसा होता है कि एक फॉर्मल प्रेजेंटेशन जैसा बन जाता है जिसमें हम अपने भाषा के एक्सेंट का वर्ड्स के सिलेक्शन में बहुत ज्यादा ध्यान देने लगते हैं. सो इट बिकम्स अ काइंड ऑफ फॉर्मल प्रेजेंटेशन दैट वी जनरली डू इन कॉर्पोरेट्स थिंग्स लाइक दैट. सो वी हैव टू अवॉइड दैट आल्सो. दीज आर सम कॉमन मिस्टेक्स. देन पेइंग अटेंशन टू ओनली फ्यू पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड इग्नोरिंग द रेस्ट. सो जनरली इन द ऑनलाइन मोड दिस मे हैपन व्हेन यू सेलेक्ट ओनली अ फ्यू पीपल फ्रॉम द participants and take up their questions. So that can be avoided. In fact, as a precaution, what I generally also try to do is, if I pick one male participant, then I pick some female participant, generally. So one male and then one female and then one male and so on. So that also gives a kind of feeling to the other person that everybody is being paid attention. You may also see that if there are people attending the workshop online across the country, and if you are able to see the region to which the other person belongs to, you may try to pick people from different regions of the country also. Many times from Northeast, very few participants are there. And if we do not take any question from them, then they may feel neglected. So this is another thing which we may note, we have to take care of while conducting the workshop. We all are able to see that this sharing is a process of dialogue, and the purpose is to initiate or strengthen self-exploration. Now, to initiate and strengthen self-exploration, to develop the capacity to find the answers rather than some answers. So we have to feel that our job is not to give just some ready-made answers and make the other memorize those answers. Rather, our job is to initiate that exploration process. We have to help the other reach one's natural acceptance. It may take time for the other to look at the response exactly as we are sharing. But if you are able to help the participant pay attention to one's natural acceptance and then reflect there, then that will be a deep takeaway for the other, because that process gets developed. So we have to evolve that process of self-exploration in the other. By just giving some ready-made answers or just by sharing something which may satisfy the other momentarily, that may get missed out. And we have to ensure that this is a dialogue and not a monologue. It's not that only I have to speak. The other also wants to share something. Now, a few things while conducting the session. So place the proposal clearly. So the proposal has to be placed very clearly. And you will see that the proposals which are there on the slides also, they are very crisp. Okay, and every selection of word has been made with a lot of care, with a lot of rigorous exercise. So we have to ensure that the same word is presented. If you try to mince words, then the clarity may get lost. Then you can clarify with short, precise examples. Place smaller proposals rather than that the other can self-explore with the given background and the coverage. So the proposal, if it is very long, then the other may miss out a part of it. So smaller proposals can be put forward so that the exploration gets initiated in the other. And while placing any proposal or responding to any question, we have to see how much of content has been covered so far, so that with the same background, I'm able to respond to the question. So for example, if somebody asks something on the day one, which relates to the feeling of trust, then it would not be very nice response to say that everybody is intentionally sound. The other has not been able to expose to that kind of content also. Then exploration is not there. And if I'm trying to base my answer on that particular thing, then the other is not able to explore also. So you have to see. So that's why you see that when we are responding on the day questions to day one, then we try to respond to the questions, keeping the correct priority of right understanding, right feeling, and physical facility in mind. Okay. Now, when you're responding on the second day, then you may talk about self and self and body and such things. When you're responding on the third day, so you have to see the background, how much has been covered so far. Then it would be a good idea to respond to the question and give some clue so that the other is able to look into one's natural acceptance and then pause. That pause is very important. If you pause at that moment, no, you'll see that the person who might not be very attentively listening to the session, okay, starts paying attention. Even if somebody is doing some work while the mobile is on and the content is being shared, if you give a pause and give some clue for exploring, other starts paying attention. This is something that we can observe out ourselves also. If someone wants to come in, seek clarification, ask a question, then welcome it. So we'll see that these questions which are being asked are a help to us and not a kind of retardation. It's not that the other person is asking to perturb me, disturb me. Okay. Sometimes one may get a feeling like this, that this person is after me. So in place of that, I can see that no, this person wants to understand. He may be or she may be deeply preconditioned on some count, but that intention is sound is something that I can see. Has been raining here, so I have got some stuff. One good practice would be in this online session, at least, that by ourselves we can ask every 5 minutes if there is any query. So every 5 minutes, presently, no. People, if you are just sharing the content, may not be that much observant to the content. May not be listening to the content. Very attentively. So we may, to keep them involved, we may ask something every 5 minutes, or we may take some reflection in the chat box. We may take reflection in the chat box, or we may raise a poll so that that connectivity remains there. Then for oneself, we can observe whether this is a dialogue or not. Okay, are we entering into a monologue? It is a dialogue. Then your own clarity about the proposal is very much required. And pausing at appropriate points is also required. Some common mistakes are that we just read the slides. But I am sure that those of us who have shared the content in the Sunday morning session also are not doing this. Okay, not just reading the slides. Then asserting, trying to convince, giving too much time to make the other understand fully. So this also needs to be avoided. Sometimes we are after the other, trying to convince the other that I'll not let this person go unless he agrees with me. Not like that. This is over-assertion. Then at some point, we see that you have also developed some kind of opposition for the other. That when I'm after somebody, making him understand, am I also having that trust on the intention? Or I am assuming that this person doesn't want to understand, something like that. Similar to just reading the slides, one common mistake could be just going to the table of contents, something like metadata, okay, or using adjectives that trying to overemphasize the content. Then assessing or condemning the present state. This is another common mistake. So instead of focusing on solution, the bulk of the time is used for talking about problems. So this is to be avoided. Then rushing through the content and not keeping time for interaction. So if you see, the sessions now have been planned in such a way, and particularly with the design of session that we have now, when we are giving another 1 hour for sharing the content, there is no need to rush through the content. Earlier on day two and day four, we had to rush a lot. On day four also, we have reduce the content a bit, and on day two we are now having 1 hour extra time, so there is no need to rush through the content. So we do have to keep time for interaction. And then one common mistake could be getting carried away from the points to be covered. So maybe while sharing some example or detailing upon something, one may get carried away. So this is also to be avoided. I'm not able to take questions from you at this moment because there's some limitation of time, but I'll try to finish off and then take questions from you. Then there is also a need for appraisal of present state while sharing the content. So there are a few things have to be taken care of. So avoiding appraisal as far as possible. An appraisal, if at all doing, it does not have to be a kind of criticism. We start criticizing, then some people may feel opposed to us. So while appraising the current state, we have to ensure that the purpose is to take the attention of the other to the proposal and not condemning the present state, condemning any kind of thing, because intentionally everyone is sound. This is something that I have to see within me very clearly. So leave it to the participant after providing the yardstick. So we have to see how this person can observe the reality. For that, if I can share something, and that needs my own competence. If I'm able to see that at the core, this particular issue is there, which the other person not able to articulate also. So I share something which will help the other find out the answer by oneself. That would be very good. Rajul, you want to say something?
Yeah, I was thinking that, you know, one line example for each of these points would be quite useful. So when we are talking about any of these points, does appraisal mean and so on. So it will be very helpful.
So while doing some appraisal of the current state, one may say that the current state of education is not good. आज की शिक्षा बिल्कुल व्यर्थ हो गई है. माँ बाप के बच्चे सुनते नहीं हैं. बच्चे पैसे के पीछे भाग रहे हैं. And so on so forth. ऐसे बहुत सारे उदाहरण हम दे सकते हैं. ठीक. अब उससे या तो हो सकता है कि अगला व्यक्ति उससे disagree करे. The other person disagrees to this and feels opposed. Or the other person will feel depressed. You know, everything is going in the wrong direction. Many times this has also happened when we're conducting the workshops face to face, and if the resource person had not taken care of this point, then some participants felt so depressed that they did not join the workshop on the next day. So isko avoid karna hai. So jaise humne shiksha ki alochna shuru kar di, ya system mein jo kuch chal raha hai uski alochna shuru kar di, ya jis tarah se prakriti ki hum sthiti bana li uski alochna shuru kar di, aur alochna hi karte chale gaye. उससे फिर अगले व्यक्ति के अंदर मोटिवेशन नहीं बनता समझने के लिए. Now leaving it to the participant after providing the yardstick. So what could be the yardstick? Let's say हम कह रहे हैं कि शिक्षा की स्थिति ठीक नहीं है अभी, कुछ हद तक बताना भी जरूरी है, अदरवाइज अगला व्यक्ति रिलेट नहीं कर पाता करंट स्टेट से, उसको लगता है कि बहुत ही आदर्शवादी बातें हो रही हैं, बहुत ही अलग तरह की बातें हो रही हैं। तो वी मे ट्राई टू हेल्प द अदर रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन द करंट स्टेट, बट एट द सेम टाइम वी हैव टू सी हाउ द अदर पर्सन कैन टेक अ शिफ्ट। तो अभी भी शिक्षा की अगर हम बात करें तो हम ये कह सकते हैं कि शिक्षा में अभी इस बात का स्कोप तो आया है, AICT ने इस कोर्स को इंक्लूड किया है, कई यूनिवर्सिटी ने इंक्लूड किया है ताकि अगले व्यक्ति के अंदर मोटिवेशन बने इस बात को सुनने समझने के लिए। अब अगर कुछ और उदाहरण लें, जैसे मान लीजिए ट्रस्ट की बात कर रहे हैं, रिलेशनशिप की बात कर रहे हैं, so while giving some example which is an appraisal of the current state, one may say that had there been the trust on intention in the same scenario, then what would have happened? This may help as a yardstick for the other to look into the solution in the given situation. Now if we overdo this part, the participants may get into opposition or go away with like things are really bad, nothing can be done. Okay, they may feel depressed. So we want participants to be able to see the harmony, the holistic solution, which they can understand and slowly implement in their life. And then only I can be complimentary to the other. So it requires perseverance on our part. If you see the way we have been progressing by attending the workshop or conducting the sessions or sharing the values, we'll see that there is a shift in our perseverance. Now we are able to persevere, and this is something which is an authentication of our development. So that kind of perseverance is required while conducting the workshop, not being irritated or angry, but rather being able to see every moment that there is a way out, there is a solution here, and this person has to observe this, and I have to be helped there. Next thing is something which I stated, that while giving examples of demonstrating the current state, you can also help the person visualize what would happen in the same scenario with right feeling. For example, when we take an example of trust, so we share one example that a professor at Kanpur, he got a heart attack because his wife spoke certain words which he could not tolerate. And then we try to see that if the person had trust on intention, then what would have happened. So in that example, we say that, did you get hurt because of the words that the wife spoke, or due to some doubt on her intention that she wanted to make you unhappy? And then we try to reflect that, yes, it was the doubt on intention. Now we can add one tag here. Now let's see, if the person had trust on intention, then what would have been the outcome? If you say this and give a pause, then the participant may try to reflect in one's own living. Yes, this could be there. So, aisa ho sakta hai ki wife ghar ke kharchon ko lekar bahut pareshan hai. Aur humne, something which is shared in that example is that a person from Calcutta had come to that professor and demanded some money, and this person gave money to the friend without consulting his wife, and then his wife got so offended that she spoke some very hurting word, and this person got heart attack out of that. Now if the person had trust or intention, then he might feel that maybe the wife is concerned about the expenses in the family, or something which is going to be a very kind of severe expense in the future, कोई बहुत बड़ा खर्च होने वाला है निकट भविष्य में, बच्चे की शादी करनी है कुछ ऐसा, और इसलिए कंसर्न है, इसलिए ऐसी बात कह दी। और the wife might have felt कि why didn't he consult me? Had I said no, if you would have consulted me, something like that. So then this will open up new channels for exploration for the participant. So this is something that we can try to see while sharing the examples. Now, while doing this, while giving an appraisal of the current state, you can observe your feeling whether this is for mutual development or not. Even if we are able to see that there are people in the society who are harming the society, is their intention sound? Can I be a help to the other? This is something that I have to keep observing. Okay. And of course, I am getting some feeling of opposition, domination, then this is not something to be welcomed and something to be continued. Now, the common mistakes here could be insisting that this is the current state. कई बार ऐसा होता है कि जब हम करंट सिचुएशन का अप्रेजल कर रहे होते हैं तो हम कहने लगते हैं ऐसा ही है. Now, maybe to a large extent, it's not there. Or to some extent, it's not there. To a large extent, it's there. And some person may start disagreeing with you. Then what will it do? This generally happens when we are giving an appraisal of the current state. If everybody agrees also, then also it may not be a very good thing because people are generally used to condemn things which are happening currently. And they feel that you are a part of that process. You are also one of them. So no need to insist that this is the current state. Condemning the present state too much, being holier than thou, being judgmental, being critical, over-condemning, implying or asserting that this is the only way out, and other ways are useless. This never has to be said in the workshop, at least that this is the only way out and everything else is useless. You may feel it within that the only way to ensure right living is right understanding, but if you try to assert it, then the other may feel somewhat distanced from you. Saying something which may not fulfill the basic guidelines. So, here, sometimes our expression due to some habit comes out while sharing some example or responding to some questions, which may lead to a feeling of differentiation in the other. Differentiating between communities, differentiating between gender, some saying something which is not universal, or at some point of time start preaching, giving do's and don'ts. So this is something which may happen as a mistake and one has to take care of. Now I am saying so many things from my side, but let me say that while conducting the session, we may not be able to keep all these points in our mind or attending to all these points at the same time. But at least if we become observant that this is required, then gradually we develop that competence. So let me say that while sharing the values in the workshop, you have to be relaxed also. While giving so many points, it's not that you become so much cautious about your presentation that you lose your confidence also. This is not desirable. This is something on the flip side that you have to take care of. Now, while responding to the questions, so what can be taken care of? So when they start respond with their name and welcome, a kind of welcoming word, listen to the whole question or comment, interrupt only in exceptional cases. Interruptions might be required in some cases when some person gives a very kind of long response to your question or start sharing from one's own side, which is very long and may take a lot of time, and others may feel somewhat anxious about this sharing, why this sharing is continuing for so long. So then we may interrupt, rephrase the question or comment if formulation is not clear. Yeah, this is something which is quite necessary. Many times the participant himself or herself is not clear what he or she wants to ask. So one may attempt by giving a very crisp kind of question to the other that this is what he wanted to ask. Is that fine? And then respond to that. You can validate that this is the question or comment. And if they interrupt, then listen first. Short, crisp answer, keeping in mind what has been covered so far and the type of workshop and not going beyond this. This is something that we said earlier also. So, for example, if it is an introductory workshop and we are aware of the whole content that is going to be shared in the introductory workshop, so aisa hum koi baat na rakhe jo ki uske aage kisi workshop mein cover hona hai. Itna tak simit rakhe. Haan, parantu yadi kisi ki jigyasa hai, तो बहुत ही क्रिस्प ढंग से कह सकते हैं कि ये इसका रिस्पांस हो सकता है, परंतु आप इसको ओपन रखें और आगे जब आप वर्कशॉप में आएंगे तो इस पे और ठीक से बात होगी. सो दिस इज वन पॉसिबिलिटी, बट वी हैव टू कीप आवरसेल्व्स एज मच एज पॉसिबल कन्फाइंड टू द कंटेंट व्हिच इज देयर फॉर द करंट वर्कशॉप. जी मनीषा दीदी कुछ कहना चाह रही हैं?
जी भैया अभी जो लेटेस्ट हमारी वर्कशॉप हुई थी उसमें एक प्रश्न हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट थे उनका आ रहा था इवनिंग में भी और मॉर्निंग में भी, तो उनका प्रश्न जैसे था कि पहले तो आप सारे मैनेजमेंट को और सबको समझाइए और AICTE को ध्यान नहीं देता है इन बातों पर और आप कंप्लेन करिए, इस तरह से वो बहुत एडमेंटली मॉर्निंग में भी कर रहे थे। और हमने अपनी तरफ से जो हमें हमारी समझ के आधार पर जितना हम रिस्पॉन्स दे सकते थे, फिर फाइनली परीक्षित भैया को भी उसमें बटन करना पड़ा और उन्होंने कहा कि भाई ये सारी ये प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं है इन चर्चाओं को करना, हम इसको फीडबैक में अपने, मैंने भी ये बात कही थी। तो इस तरह के जब बहुत एक एडमेंट वाले एक प्रश्न आ जाते हैं और पार्टिसिपेंट भी अपने प्रश्न पर बिल्कुल अडिग रहते हैं और थोड़ा थोड़ा अपने फोर्सफुली उसको पुट अप करते हैं, तो उस जगह पर हमें अपने आप को मतलब उस जगह पर हम तो संतुलन में हैं, हम हार्मनी में हैं, लेकिन हम पार्टिसिपेंट को थोड़ा स्पेसिफाई या थोड़ा कैसे करें ये बात।
दो तीन चीजें हम क्रिस्प आंसर दे दें वहां पर जो भी हमको वहां पर उचित लगता है, कि साथ में कहें कि इस तरह के इश्यूज को लेकर हम लोग बाद में भी बात कर सकते हैं, आप हमें इस नंबर पे कॉल कर लीजिए और हम लोग इस पे डिस्कशन कर सकते हैं। ना लेट मी शेयर वन थिंग हियर, ये क्लासरूम में भी कोर्स को पढ़ाते समय कई बार बच्चे कई बार ऐसे प्रश्न उठते हैं, तो आप पाएंगे कि बच्चे कहते हैं कि पहले टीचर को समझाओ, टीचर कहते हैं मैनेजमेंट को समझाओ, मैनेजमेंट कहता है गवर्नमेंट को समझाओ, गवर्नमेंट कहती है पब्लिक को समझाओ। So many times we are trying to share, trying to put the responsibility on the other. So everybody needs to understand. So कई बार ऐसा भी होता है कि किसी प्रश्न बहुत ही गंभीर प्रश्न का उत्तर बहुत ही सहज भाव से अगर हम दे दें जो थोड़ा ह्यूमर भी हो उसमें, तो अगला व्यक्ति संतुष्ट हो जाता है। ऐसा कई बार फेस टू फेस वर्कशॉप में तो दिखाई देता ही है, और इसको हम लोग ऑनलाइन में भी कर सकते हैं। हमें भी समझने की जरूरत है, किसी का कॉम्पिटेंस कम हो सकता है, किसी का ज्यादा हो सकता है, हमें भी समझने की जरूरत है। इस तरह के रिस्पॉन्स को देते हैं, पर यदि कोई इसके ऊपर भी इंसिस्ट करता है तो हम कह सकते हैं कि ये करेक्ट प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं है, मैंने इस प्रश्न का एक उत्तर दिया और आप उसको थोड़ा उस पर ध्यान दीजिए, और यदि कोई पर्टिकुलर इशू पे बात करनी है तो हम लोग बाद में बात कर सकते हैं, इस सेशन के बाद बात कर सकते हैं। ठीक है दीदी?
जी भैया, ऐसा ही हमने अपने उससे किया, और बट वो जैसे था ना कि शाम में भी फिर वही प्रश्न आएगा, फिर अगले दिन सुबह भी वही प्रश्न। जी भैया, ठीक बात है जी।
And responding with wide fundamental answer covering individual, family, society, nature, time frame. So we may respond to the question very precisely and then share something which opens up new channels for exploration, so that other is able to see the role of this particular response in understanding the harmony at every level in the complete expanse of living. So one can see for oneself also that when I'm responding to a particular question, my response is not only going to address this particular question, but this is going to extend one's exploration to the complete expanse of living. For that, we may add a few things from our side also. For example, यदि कोई व्यक्ति परिवार के किसी एक संबंध को लेकर पूछ रहा है प्रश्न, somebody is asking between, let's say, husband-wife relationship, so we may respond to that question. But at the same time, we can see that husband is also a human being, wife is also a human being, and the same thing reflects to every human-human relationship. So many times while talking about relationship, people start observing only the relationship inside the family. Okay, and that also with immediate person, maybe spouse or child, and they are not able to look at the complete scenario. So ye hum open up kar sakte hain. Keep pausing to let them interject, respond. Okay. So while giving a response also, it's not a very long-wound response that is expected. Give some response, pause, take some response again, and then respond to the person again, and then summing up if the dialogue is long. So many times when the dialogue takes place at a stretch, then you may like to come back to the original point after some sum up, so that others are also able to relate to the role of this particular discussion in the entire process. Then after the interaction, recall and repeat the proposal being discussed. So this is something while something to be taken care of while responding to the questions. Rajul bhaiya kuch kehna chahe.
So I was saying that, you know, when we are talking about problems in the individual or in the family, for example, there is always this kind of question that how can you trust a terrorist or something like that. You know? So in the answer, if we can include that this person has reached to this state because, you know, the right kind of education was probably not available, or the kind of family background that this person has was not, you know, background of relationship. So like that, you can extend that answer and then come back to the point that this question has been asked in the session on relationships, then you expand on the relationship part. If this kind of question has been asked in the society, then you can expand on the education part, etc. But the width of the answer is would be nice. And ultimately, many of the answers will come back to ensuring the right kind of education in the family, in the society, in the media, and all.
Then, while responding to the question, so we can clarify that part of the reality, that is the meaning of that reality, which is not yet clear. So that has to be clarified. So many times people listen to some word. Now you are trying to relate some reality to that word, but the other person has something as a preconditioning, as a meaning associated with that word. So you'll see that the dialogue is not taking place. You are talking about some reality and saying some word, and that word is being received in relation to something else. So that response is not reaching to the other. So we have to be observant about this also. Many times while having a dialogue, it occurs later that, okay, I was trying to say something, but the other person was taking it for something else. Okay. In fact, this word I or self, okay, this is something which is very common to each one of us. So when we are uttering this word, it's not that the sense in which I am trying to use this word, the same sense is being taken away by the other also. It may differ. So that's how we have to go for elaboration and detailing out and so many things. For example, Suvidha. In Hindi, we call it that Suvidha, physical facility. Now, in Hindi, you see that generally people, when they ask a question, they take this word Suvidha to be facilities over and above the basic necessities. So they do not use this word Suvidha for the basic necessities like food, clothes, shelter. Now you see that a person is asking a question, but he is relating to the word Suvidha to the facilities over and above the basic necessities. And you are not observant about that. You are not able to see that. And that's how the response is not reaching to the other. So this is something which is to be taken care of. And then there is no need for any glorification or belief or mysticism, etc. You have to give the exact response to the question so that the other is able to see the reality. Then highlight the purpose, the participation, the value of that part of the reality without being a critic. Then help the other to explore, verify, and not try to. Connection had got lost. I think it is there again. माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल
यस भैया
जी जी अब ठीक है
सो वी माइट ओनली नीड टू एक्नॉलेज वंस रिस्पांस देयर इज नो नीड टू रिस्पोंड फर्दर टू दिस सो दिस कम्स ग्रेजुअली व्हेन वी डेवलप दैट फीलिंग ऑफ रिलेशनशिप विद द पार्टिसिपेंट सो रादर देन agreeing or disagreeing and we may only acknowledge and then move ahead so observe your feeling how I can help the other to understand or how I can shut up the other etc so the purpose is not to shut up the other the purpose is to help the other understand the common mistakes that could be there not connecting person to person not acknowledging them just giving instructions to unmute etc we can hear you go ahead this kind of words can be avoided not listening or keeping on interrupting trying to answer everything as if it is your viva voce examination yeah this is also a common kind of mistake so we try to satisfy the other person by all means and then you know we try to answer everything in one go which is to be avoided Then raising or getting involved in controversial issues, of course, this is never to be done because a single controversial word used by us can spoil the whole workshop. Just repeating the proposals, this is also not required. In fact, this will you will be able to overcome this particular thing with some time only, because. because when fresh questions come no and you are not exactly able to see at that moment what the response should be so in place of saying that I don't know or I will have to think it's better to say something so one may repeat the proposal so that at least the other is able to get some response but that sharpness of response will come gradually so we can see that this is avoided to a large extent or as much as possible Then giving very long answers, dominating, trying to convince, of course not required. Addressing some other issue rather than the one raised. Now, some person is asking about a particular thing, but maybe the source person is not able to see that this is the particular issue. So the person has spoken, let's say 50 words. The question was pointed at some particular issue, maybe the issue of lack of feeling of relationship. And he used the word competition. And we started talking about competition. Well, what was to be addressed directly was trust. And the response got missed out. So it so happened that the person asked the question again, we say something again, and then the other person says that, okay, not possible to get answer at this particular time or from this person. And then the other person just shuts up, okay, leave it. So this is something that we have to ensure that this doesn't happen. But this will also again come with time. Cross questioning, counter questioning. Now, cross questioning could be a help only to help the other reflect onto the reality. But cross questioning to shut up the other or counter questioning to shut up the other is of course not required. Then giving prescriptions, ready-made answers, so of course you have talked about this not to be taken up. Now, during the session, if you see, so. While conducting the session, so our own introduction and your motivation to share in the first lecture with enthusiasm and liveliness is required. State session topic very clearly. Initiate dialogue, connecting to the participants and the topic to real life. Discuss it as a series of connected key points, something that we have been sharing in almost every session on Sunday morning. So basically the whole workshop is a series of connected sub proposals okay so we have to ensure this then we have to keep the key point as a proposal then expand and explain it then take small real life examples to exemplify the key point with enthusiasm and liveliness then ask questions to the participants to explore the key point ask the participants if they are able to explore the key point pausing in between giving time for self exploration responding to clarifications questions observations returning to the key point Okay. And then sum up the topic and then go back and start a fresh proposal with this particular guideline. So this is something which is required and give points of self-reflection as homework. So maybe in every session, we can give something which directly pertains to living. And that helps one reflect on the understanding part. For example, if you ask somebody to count the number of clothes, okay, then that becomes a good exercise. In the face-to-face workshop, we used to give an assignment that, okay, try to count how many times you took off from the session mentally. So we were saying something, but you got carried away by some word or some elaboration, and then you started thinking about something else. And each one of us has done this exercise, counting out takeoffs. So this is something that we can give as a homework. And then avoiding hesitations, then using word like, they are like each one of us is habituated to utter a few words repeatedly, like or right or hana or theek hai. So we have to be observant for that also, that am I using some word very repeatedly? If yes, then I can try to avoid it. Then for observation, so the feeling of the presenter, so we have to be observant of our feeling, whether the proposal has been placed clearly versus just as an imposition. Pausing after proposing, precise and relevant examples given, whether this is there or not. Let me look at the chat. Something message has been given. Okay. Yeah, maybe I'll finish off in next few minutes. Maybe another session we can take where the clarity about the proposals can be taken up. So that I'll not cover in this part. Questions to help the other to reflect to the proposal rather than to only evaluate the current state. Then response to the questions. So listening without interruption, reformulation if required, short crisp answer pertaining to the participant rather than repeating the content or an example, etc. Along with smaller proposals, something that we said earlier, just a kind of helping you pay attention to this again, that the other participant can explore and discover the answer for themselves. Validating with the participant, did the answer help them to move toward discovering the answer themselves or not? Common mistakes could be just going on speaking without any pause. Okay, in fact, in this particular session, I'm going on speaking because there's some limitation of time and the content is too much. Otherwise, I would have taken pause and taken some questions also. Examples look like advertisement for the workshop, not to be done at all, rather than clarifying the proposal. Questions are to evaluate, condemn present state rather than to reflect on the proposals. So now, of course, we talked about this not to be taken care of. Dreary that everything is very bad versus being uplifting and solution oriented. So in place of condemning, we have to see the possibility ahead. And in fact, we can share this also during the workshop that this much of work has happened already. This much of possibility is there. So that's how we also ask during the recap that are you able to see something within you with the discussion that we have so far. Changing the content or process. So this is something not to be done. This is something that we have covered already, but so before do all types of tasks like coordination, take part, teaching part, make detailed note of the session to be conducted. During the session, be aware, observant. And then after the session, this is very much important, review one's own recording, take detailed feedback from someone you trust, self-explore, refine. We'll elaborate on this part. Then as a preparation, you can see that you have attended at least 1 3-day or 7-day or 8-day offline or 5-day online UHB FDP, are exploring within regularly, are teaching or interested to teach UHB course, are volunteering in UHB related activities, have identified their mentor, and are taking regular guidance from her or him. So each one of us does require a mentor to begin with, at least. Then have gone through and made notes of this particular session that how to share values, the guidelines for resource persons, you know, or we have gone through the teacher's manual, we have did the handouts and the textbook. And we have also gone through some session where the process for development of RPs has been shared. Then you can attend the workshop like UHB 1, 2, 3, and 4. So far, I think you have mostly been exposed. Those who are in the workshop online have mostly been exposed to UHB 1 and refresher. But this UHB 2, which is refresher part 2, is yet to be conducted online. And we are also thinking to conduct it offline. So that will also add to your preparation. So the resources are available here. I think we all are acquainted with this. I will briefly go over it. So the detailed syllabus is available, teacher's manual is there, textbook is there, handouts are there, presentations are there, videos are there, website is there. Various FTPs have been conducted, their recording is available. Weekly meetings are there. These weekly meetings are very important. In fact, those of us who have been coming to the weekly meetings are able to make progress much faster. Then the panel of experts is there, resource persons are there. We have a committed team now, and the team is growing day by day. Now, you all who are there in the session right now are part of the team. Then the steps for implementation has also been shared. You can take a note of that. Now, preparing for the presentation. So while conducting a workshop, some preparation is required. So what can be done? So go through the slides and see if every word and diagram is clear to you. Okay, it's not that some word comes afresh to you during the workshop or some diagram is not clear to you. Listen to the audio recordings of few resource persons, record a video of your own, note down the areas for improvement, go through the recordings of FAQs. You may also make a list of examples to be taken and ensure that the examples are able to convey the meaning of the content being shared and that they obey all the basic guidelines of UHV. To begin with, when you start conducting a session, this last point has to be done seriously, because sometimes our examples may not reflect the content directly or may not fulfill the basic guideline. Okay, or maybe too much condemning the current scenario or wrongly evaluating some person or some something, or maybe taking something from mythology or something, okay, which may not fulfill the basic guideline. So this thing has to be taken care of. Then ways to improve the delivery of the UHV content. So note down the evaluation shared with you. This is something to be done after you conducted the session. Listen to the recordings of the delivery made by you. Note down the scope for further improvement and make another recording of your own, trying to incorporate all the points and listen to them again. Okay, so this is something to be done after the workshop. So the content and process is there. I'll not go over it again, but I think through the discussion that we had so far, we are able to cover all this. So most important that, are we listening to the question of the audience as it is, or we start creating argument to convince him before finishing the audience question? This is something that we discussed. We should ensure that our examples should help the audience to see the reality rather than to sensitize them as to what is happening in the absence of that reality. So in place of talking about the lack of right understanding, we have to talk about the right understanding and its implications in our living. Then points to be taken care of while listening to the recordings of the other resource persons. So generally the beginners, the persons who are going to be resource persons, and in brief it is called as TBRP, try to focus the way questions are handled. And many times we focus on questions and their answers. Actually, answers of RPs include the audience background and their competence and may vary according to their audience. So every time, ultimately, you have to be able to see the reality and not be influenced by some particular aspect of sharing by the other. Response to some question, elaboration on some content or some kind of example. We may get carried away by that. We remain under that influence for a short period of time, but since the right understanding has not been addressed adequately, so miss out the transformation within us. TBRPs should focus how the senior resource persons are consistent of delivering the reality, the main objective of the workshop, uninfluenced by the questions asked during the workshop. And while listening to the question and answer of the recording, TBRP should also focus on how RPs understand the crux of the question and take the individual towards reality. Note the question being asked in the recording and ask yourself whether you are able to see the absence of reality which is creating the question. There is some limitation of time, otherwise I would have elaborated with some examples here, but let me move forward. So again, some guidelines here. So for regular preparation, reading the UHV handouts, UHV book, teaching notes, PPTs, listening to the workshop audios, then watching and listening to the workshop audios, videos. A week before the session, what can be done? So this is something that was suggested by Umesh Bhaiya. So let's say the session is on Sunday. So on Monday, you can record the audio of your own session. Then on Tuesday, you can check with the session guidelines for RP or PRP. Wednesday, detail out the required improvement if necessary. Thursday, re-record the session. Friday and Saturday, final presentation and finishing touch. And Sunday, relax and help the participant to verify within with feeling of relationship. So this is something, but not exactly to be done this particular way. I would say you have to do the same thing on that particular day, but there is some guideline for you. If you do this, then it will be much better. Your delivery of content will be much better. Okay, I'll not go into this. So yeah, so I think I have done enough with my sharing here. I can take up some questions. Maybe Rajul Bhaiya can guide us. How much time do we have to take up the questions? In fact, this had 45 slides altogether, and covering 45 slides in 45 minutes is also a very fast thing. So yes, Rajul Bhaiya.
Yeah, so there are about 55 participants, or were 55, now there are 40 participants. How many of you have taken notes in this? If you can raise your hand. Very nice. So those of you who have taken notes or have any, you know, specific takeaways or any specific questions, and that would be nice if you can answer those. That would be very nice, because it is this session was little too fast.
Fast, yeah.
Yeah. So
it was little. So many. Sorry to interrupt. So many things were coming, but I could not take all the notes because slides were going little faster. And yeah. If you get this content in as a PP means a soft copy, it would have been nice. We could read once more, no?
Yeah, yeah. The soft copy will be shared with you, and also the recording will be put on the YouTube so that you can, you know, revisit it.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. But right now, if we can clarify something, you can ask.
In the beginning, let me say that in the beginning, it was expected that I could go over the content in Hindi as well as English, at least the key points in Hindi. But there was some limitation of time also. I did try to do this, but again, limitation of time, I could not do it in detail.
Kumar, I think what we can do is to record it at leisure with examples and all that and put it on YouTube.
So okay, that,
yeah, that will be a good asset for us, and it, if it can be done in the live audience kind of thing, that is also fine, but it may be good to at least make it available on YouTube.
For this, no, at least 2 to 2.5 hours is required.
Yes, I agree. It is at least that much, and I was thinking that when, like Manisha ji was sharing one question, if we have the recording of that session, we can just play that part. So we can just play parts of different recordings and as examples. So if we can do that, that will be nice. Otherwise, we can just take some specific examples for each of the points. For example, we are saying, you know, the one that I shared about having a wide answer. So we can give an example of that. Similarly, when we are you know, talking about each of these points in the beginning also, you can give one line or small examples.
I think then we have to plan something like a day long session, let's say, so that we can take questions pertaining to all these issues.
I think at least that 1.5 hours or up to 3 hours, we can do a recording and put it, and then people can go through it and at their leisure. They may take more time, they may take a whole day to go over it, but that is fine. But if the points are there with examples, it would be quite helpful.
So to and do yes, that, I will also have to do this particular thing. On Monday, I record my session, and then on Tuesday, I do something. And
yes, true, very true. So it's very nice to see that, you know, that notes are being taken and there are takeaways. So let us take one takeaway from somebody who has had a good takeaway from this session. And then maybe we can close because it is already almost time now. Anybody with a strong takeaway?
Or some question also, if possible. Priya Didi had raised the hand. Then Rabinji also has raised.
Sir, namaste, sir. Sir, is it possible to be part of the resource person to say spare time to have personal guidance while preparing? Is it possible, sir? Particularly, sir, Sambhav, sir, can you spare some few times as part of developing the?
Yes, sir. Yes, you can have my contact details. Everyone can have my contact details. If ever you want to ask something, then do make a call. Okay. If I'm not able to respond at that point of time, then I will call you back, sir. Later.
It's nice. It's great.
Yes. This is always possible.
Thank you, sir. So in a single line, I can say that the takeaway is the process of transformation. So it is a feelings on the self, what is going on. The day by day, this is the, the time is going on. So it's a slow process of changes in the self. It will take lot of time. But definitely the shift in the thought process is going on. So that is the takeaway, the process of transformation and trying to develop. That feeling is just the feelings to develop that is the important thing.
Yeah, the question is any important takeaway in terms of how to share values. So we can focus on any takeaway about that.
Yes, sir. Definitely, recordings of listening the contents and recording is very important. And recording and listening, sir, जैसे संभव चीजें हम जब बताया तो Monday recording at least once recording and listening and evaluating somebody else who will be better person to guide. So that is important. So that because. Of course, so first time sharing will not fulfill that much of, but definitely it will improve on the self, sir.
Nice. So you can do that recording and so on, so yes, others can also take something from that. So nice. Namaste, Rahulji.
Sir, for me, I recorded, but feeling part, even though inside the feeling is there, but when I'm speaking, the feeling part is not coming. I don't know, since the audience is not there, that feeling, I could, when I heard my recording, I could feel like that.
So that will gradually come. What you are sharing gives me a feeling that you are so much observant about your feeling. So that is a very good thing.
But I agree with this, Priya madam, so sharing, because in the classroom, when the students are there, we move across the area, and to share the feelings is definitely lagging with sitting in the room and recording in the mobile. So definitely there is a difference, but it's a trying to have a virtual imagination that the students are there. So it's a great thing to explore out of this online, sir.
Yeah.
Definitely there will be a difference, sir.
Yeah. We can hear from Deepak Nayarji and Anupama Godeji.
Hello, good morning, sir. Namaste, everyone.
Namaste.
Yeah, sir. Actually, I want to share this. There is a difference in sharing when we are sharing it to the students and when we are sharing it to the faculty members. Actually, before starting the sharing, first we need to explain why we are doing this process. Why we have to inform them the real objective behind this. I think more than the faculty members, especially the students, they will be able to attain that meaning, the sense that they will be able to get the need of this type of course. Means we are more matured people, we can understand it, but to a certain extent, we already have a feeling that we are experienced, we don't need to much care on this. But for the students, even though in the beginning, if they are a little bit reluctant to accept this, but if you are able to give them that feeling, the need, we are able to express the need, why do they need this? Definitely, I'm sure that they are more happy to accept such content. But to make them live according to this content is a little bit difficult. We have to follow up this in every, that means we need to continue this follow-up sessions for students. That's what I feel with when we compare it with the faculty members and with the students. So if you are able to develop that connectivity, so it's very easy with the students. Yes, thank you, sir.
Hello. Hello, meri awaaz aa rahi hai?
Ji, Anupama ji, but before that, Deepa ji, thanks for your observation. Nice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Yes, Anupama ji, bataiye. Namaste. And then we can go to Aparajita ji.
Sir, bahut sare takeaways mile hai ye session se. First of all, I need to have feeling of responsibility. And students, when I'm putting these contents in front of the students, so I have to give content of right understanding on the core. So ye jo teacher should have a feeling of fulfillment. Sukhi aur samruddha bhav, bina krodh ke, bina opposition ke bhav ke saath. So ye har pal, har kshan dekhna hoga ki hamara jo bhav hai, wo content deliver karte waqt, students are observing, and we have to observe these feelings. Aur ye jo baat kahi Kumar bhaiya ki agla samajhna chahta hai aur hum kaise use content ye rakhe ki wo samajh paaye. Bahut baar hota hai ki hum preaching mode pe aa jate hai ki yahi sahi hai, and we try to put forward the things not as a proposal. Aur ye bahut important hai, your enthusiasm and liveliness. So your expression of the content, how you're expressing, wo dikhta hai hamare, hum jab express karte hai, jab hum khud hi sukhi aur samruddh hai. So when I am happy within, that liveliness automatically comes. So ye bahut acha laga, aur ye hum feel bhi kar pate hai jab hum share karte hai kuch bhi content students ke sath. And again, that point that when you are giving online lecture, many times it happens you're paying attention to only few participants and ignoring the rest. So ye bhi acha laga ki sir ne bhaiya ne kaha ki one male one female wo puch lete the participants ko from each region. So har ek students ko kuch na kuch rehta hai, par abhi bhi mujhe lagta hai ki how to have dialogue, initiate dialogue and how to connect the participant, usme और थोड़े एफर्ट करने होंगे, क्योंकि हम कंटेंट तो हमें पता है और समझा है, हम समझ रहे हैं और वो सही भाव के साथ भी डिलीवर करते हैं, पर जो डायलॉग इनिशिएट कैसे करना है, क्योंकि वो आ जाता है सीधा सीधा फ्लो में, तो उसके ऊपर और थोड़ा वर्क करना होगा. एंड अप्रेजल ऑफ प्रेजेंट स्टेट, वो भी बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट आउट यहाँ लगा कि हम परिस्थिति जो आज की है उसको ज्यादा समीक्षा के रूप में रखते हैं, तो वो कुछ हद तक वो हमें भी सीमित करना है. एंड रिस्पॉन्डिंग टू क्वेश्चंस, अगेन टू लिसन केयरफुली एंड एक्नॉलेज देम, वो मोस्टली दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड, वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट था. एंड कॉमन मिस्टेक्स भी हम जो करते हैं वो नजर आए. एंड आस्क क्वेश्चंस टू पार्टिसिपेंट, एंड आस्क पार्टिसिपेंट इफ दे आर रियली एबल टू एक्सप्लोर द की पॉइंट्स. तो ये सारे जो यहाँ पे पॉइंटर्स जैसे रखे थे स्लाइड्स पे, तो नोट्स तो बनाए जितना हो सकता है, पर ये क्लैरिटी ऑफ प्रपोजल अभी नेक्स्ट सेशन में लेने वाले हैं, तो ये बहुत अच्छा होगा हमारे सबके लिए एक, और टेक अवे तो बहुत
अच्छा। बहुत अच्छा अनुपमा जी, इसमें कुमार ने जो कि स्टूडेंट्स हमको ऑब्जर्व करते हैं कितने बहुत सुंदर एग्जांपल्स दिए और उससे आपका ध्यान भी गया, तो हम लोग के लिए तो ये इम्पोर्टेंट एक टेक अवे हमारे लिए कि अच्छे अच्छे एग्जांपल अगर छोटे छोटे दें जो पॉइंट को क्लियर करते हैं वो हमारे लिए उपयोगी है। और आपने जिस ढंग से नोट्स लेकर के या ध्यान दे करके ये सब सुना है उससे बहुत स्पेसिफिक चीजें आप बता पा रही हैं, तो अच्छी बात, बहुत अच्छा। पराजिता जी
नमस्ते भैया, नमस्ते सभी को जी। भैया की जो शेयरिंग अभी थी ये बहुत ही उपयोगी है मेरे लिए तो, बिकॉज और जैसे बताया कि ना वीडियोज़ जो हमारे खुद के होते हैं उनको देखते हैं, क्योंकि जब ले रहे होते तो ध्यान बिल्कुल जाता नहीं है, और मेरे अभी तीन जब सेशंस हुए तो मैंने हर एक कुछ इम्प्रूव करना चाहा तो फिर कहीं और गड़बड़ हो गई, फिर कहीं अप्रूव करना कहीं और गड़बड़ हो गई, तो मतलब वो कंसिस्टेंसी इन ना दैट करेक्शन ऑल्सो इज नॉट देयर, तो इट विल कम विद प्रैक्टिस मुझे लगता है। एंड जैसे कि अभी भैया कह रहे थे ना, तो जैसे वीडियो रहता है तो हम बार बार में सुनते हैं, जैसे अभी मैंने सुन लिया सब कुछ, मगर कई सारी चीज़ें शायद मिस ही हो गई हैं, और क्या बोलना चाह रहे हैं शायद मैंने अपने हिसाब से सुना होता है उसे, तो जब मैं दोबारा उस वीडियो को देखती हूँ तो फिर मुझे लगा अच्छा ये पॉइंट तो मैंने मिस कर दिया यहाँ, तो ये जो वीडियोज़ रहते हैं तो उससे बहुत ही फ़ायदा होता है। एक बार में तो मुझे लगता नहीं वो बात पूरी की पूरी समझ में आई होती है, जब मैं वापस से दोबारा से उसको सुनती हूँ तो मेरे को अच्छा ये पॉइंट तो मैंने कहीं इनकॉर्पोरेट नहीं किया, और कॉन्स्टेंटली दिमाग मन में रहना चाहिए इस पॉइंट को। एंड प्रीचिंग की तो इतनी आदत हो गई है कि बहुत ध्यान रखने के बाद भी कुछ ना कुछ स्लाइड्स पर प्रीच कर रहे हैं ऐसा लग रहा है, कोई शब्द भी इधर उधर हो जाएंगे शायद हो जाते हैं कभी कभी, बोलना नहीं चाह रहे हैं मगर हमने ऐसे बोल दिया कि अगले को शायद बहुत ऐसे डोमिनेटिंग लग रहा है या बड़ा एरोगेंट लग रहे हैं कुछ शब्द, ऐसा लगता है मुझे कुछ प्रैक्टिस से हो पाएगा। और जैसे ये जो आप अगर ये वीडियो शेयर होगा सभी के साथ तो बहुत ही उपयोगी रहेगा, क्योंकि एक बार में सुनने से नहीं होता है, जैसे मैं उमेश भैया के साथ भी मेरी जो भी कॉन्वर्सेशन हुई मैंने कई बार सुनी उनको, और मैं उनको बता भी चुकी हूँ आपने कितनी बार मुझे बताया है, मगर फिर भी मेरा इस बात पर ध्यान ही नहीं गया था, मैंने जब दोबारा उसको सुना फिर ध्यान आया अच्छा हाँ ये बात आप इस तरह से बोलना चाह रहे हैं, तो ये रिकॉर्डिंग्स बहुत ही उपयोगी रहती हैं भैया। और बस प्रयास मतलब प्रैक्टिस तो करनी पड़ेगी, प्रैक्टिस के बगैर नहीं होगा, और क्योंकि सामने लोग हैं नहीं जिनसे हम बात कर रहे हैं तो कई बार पता नहीं चलता कि शायद सामने फेस टू फेस होंगे तो उस तरह से नहीं बोलेंगे, मगर अभी लगता है कोई कौन सुन मतलब वो सब आर्टिफिशियल एनवायरनमेंट है तो उस तरह से भाव में गड़बड़ हो जाती है कई बार, तो मुझे लगता है प्रैक्टिस से ही हो पाएगा भैया। और बहुत बहुत आपकी ये जो शेयरिंग थी बहुत बढ़िया थी, सभी एग्जांपल्स भी बहुत अच्छे थे, और कोशिश करूंगी कि इसको इनकॉर्पोरेट कर पाऊँ, धन्यवाद भैया।
इसमें हमको तीन चीजें लगती हैं, एक तो अपना खुद का एक्सप्लोरेशन वाला पार्ट जो है वो इम्पोर्टेंट है, सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है अपना एक्सप्लोरेशन का, अपना व्यवहार का, वो सारा कुछ सब बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट। जैसे हम अगर पूछ रहे हैं दूसरे से कि तुमने अपने कपड़े काउंट किए हैं और हमने खुद ही नहीं किए हैं, तो फिर वो थोड़ा आर्टिफिशियल लगता है कि हम पूछ तो रहे हैं लेकिन हमने खुद ही नहीं किया एक्सेट्रा, तो वो एक इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट है अपने जीने में, कितना हम देख पा रहे हैं, कितना हम एक्सप्लोर कर पा रहे हैं ऑल दैट। और दूसरा पार्ट जो है वो एक तरह से कला का प्रैक्टिस का पार्ट भी है, जैसे टीचिंग में तो पहले वाले से अपना भाव स्थिर होने का काम हो पाता है, और जो दूसरा वाला पार्ट है उसके अंदर दूसरे तक जो बात है वो संप्रेषित हो पाती है, वो उसके उसको कम्युनिकेट हो पाती है, तो ये दोनों पार्ट के ऊपर ध्यान देना है। जो कला वाला पार्ट है उसके बहुत सारे पॉइंट्स हम लोग ने लिख कर रखे हैं यहाँ पर, बट उसके मूल में तो अपनी खुद की गति है। So I was saying that there are two parts. One is our own development, our own exploration, and what is coming in our own, you know, behavior and what is expressed outside, our own feeling. So that is one important part. And with that, when we go to share things, then there is some aspect of the technique. So the important part is the first one. The technique is what we have written down in these slides to some extent. So, but it is the first part that is important, our own feeling. If we have to very much pinpoint the key thing, it is our own understanding and our own feeling which is important. And then when it goes across, for example, we are saying it should be live. It will be live automatically if the feeling is one of relationship. So I think a lot of work has to be done on our end also, and at the end of each and every one of us. अभी और लोग बताएं
जी, धन्यवाद
कुमार, आप बताएं या और लोग बताना चाहें कुछ तो मेसी बताएं, शर्मिला जी बताएं
जी,
और अपराजिता ऑल द बेस्ट, आपने बहुत अच्छे से ध्यान दे करके सुना है, वेरी नाइस, एंड योर टेक अवे इज दैट यू विल डू योर रिकॉर्डिंग एंड कीप इट यू नो कीप ऑन लुकिंग एट थिंग्स एंड इंप्रूविंग.
यस जरूर भैया, नमस्ते.
उमेश जी है तो उमेश जी बताए अगर कुछ.
ये सारी बातें कुमार भैया से, और हाँ. मैं भी हो ही रहा, मैं केवल इतना ही कहना चाहता था कि ये जो वर्कशॉप्स के सेशंस के प्रिपरेशन के लिए भी ये एक बहुत वैल्यूबल गाइडेंस बना रहेगा ना ये वीडियो. साथ ही साथ हमारे जो क्लास में सेशंस लेते हैं उसके लिए भी एक वैल्यूबल गाइडेंस बना रहता है. तो जब भी हम वैल्यूज़ को शेयर करने की बात करते हैं, फॉर्मल तरीके से हो या इनफॉर्मल तरीके से भी, वर्कशॉप, क्लासरूम में टीचिंग या फ्रेंड्स के साथ में अगर हम डिस्कशंस कर रहे हैं और वहाँ वैल्यू शेयर कर रहे हैं, तो ये तीनों बातें बहुत महत्वपूर्ण दिखती है. कॉन्टेंट की क्लैरिटी और कंटेंट को प्लेस करते रहना, साथ ही साथ हमारी जो फीलिंग्स है, ये फीलिंग्स हम ये वैल्यू शेयर कर रहे हैं उसके पीछे दो यू नो रीजंस है. एक तो ये है कि जो हमारा संबंध है दूसरों के साथ में, उस संबंध का निर्वाह हम कर रहे हैं, और जो दूसरा रीज़न है वो पहले से भी बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है. ये संबंध का निर्वाह करते हुए मैं अपने में गति कर रहा हूँ. हम तो ये शेयर कर रहे हैं हमारी अपनी समझ को, भाव को बढ़ाने के लिए, स्थिर होने के लिए. और तीसरा जो मुद्दा है कि जब भी हम वैल्यूज़ को शेयर करें तो वो प्रपोजल्स के फॉर्म में बनी रही तो दूसरा भी उसको स्वीकार कर पाता है. इतनी एक बात है ना जो ऑलरेडी कुमार भैया ने कही थी, बस उसको ही मैंने रिपीट किया. जी भैया
बहुत अच्छा. आप जो लोगों की सेशन के पहले तैयारी करा दे रहे हैं ना, वो बहुत ही यूजफुल है. तो ये भी हम सबको बताना चाहेंगे कि आप जो जिस तरह से तैयारी करा दे रहे हैं लोगों की, उससे उनकी गति में बहुत सारा सहयोग हो जा रहा है. सभी लोग करेंगे तो बहुत हम लोग एक और उभर पाएंगे इसमें. तो धन्यवाद उमेश जी. शर्मिला जी कुछ कहना चाहेंगे
जी? नमस्ते सबको. कुमार भैया ने तो काफी एक्सटेंसिव सब कवर ही हो गया है. एंड जैसा उमेश जी बोल रहे थे, ये एक बहुत अच्छा रिसोर्स हो जाएगा सबके लिए, रेडिली अवेलेबल रहेगा कि जब भी चाहा उसको रेफर कर सकें. मैं एक चीज़ सोच रही थी जो मुझे लगा कि अक्सर क्या होता है कि जब हम प्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं तो हमारा ध्यान अपनी ओर रहता है कि हम ठीक से बोल रहे हैं कि नहीं, हमारा आवाज़ ठीक है कि नहीं, हम डायलॉग डिलीवरी ठीक है कि नहीं. तो उस सब से हट के अगर हम स्टूडेंट पे फोकस जाता है हमारा, कि हमारे सामने जो स्टूडेंट है वो समझना चाह ही रहा है और उसके लिए मतलब मुझे जितना भी मालूम है मैं उसको कैसे बेस्ट दूसरे की तरफ पहुंचा पाऊं, उसका सोच के जब हम बात करते हैं तो और एक बहुत नेचुरल सहज तरीके से हम बोल पाते हैं। बल्कि जब हम ऑन द अदर हैंड जब हम अपने ऊपर ध्यान रखते हैं कि मैं ठीक बोल रही हूँ कि नहीं, मैं मेरा मतलब जो मैं बात कर रही हूँ मतलब मैं अपने पर्सपेक्टिव से सोचते जा रहे हैं, तो फिर मैं मेरा ध्यान उस पर जाता है कि मैं मेरा प्रेजेंटेशन आर्टिकुलेट है कि नहीं या उन चीज़ों पर, और वो जो फीलिंग पार्ट है वो नेचुरली इतना स्टूडेंट के पर्सपेक्टिव से नहीं आ पाता। बट जब मैं स्टूडेंट की तरफ से देखती हूँ और स्टूडेंट को ना कौन सा स्टूडेंट है, मेरा ऑडियंस क्या है, उस हिसाब से सोच के अगर मैं बात करती हूँ तो एक ईज़ के साथ स्टूडेंट से रिलेट करके वो बात आगे आ पाती है। ये मैं अपने लिए देख पा रही थी तो मैंने कहा मैं मेंशन कर देती हूँ। आई डोंट नो इफ इट वाज क्लियर बट मुझे लगता है कि वो चीज़ भी एक बहुत यूजफुल चीज़ है, तो उतना ही कितना था।
बहुत अच्छा, ये जो वीकली मीटिंग हो रही है इसमें भी ये सब बातें हो बहुत ही अच्छा रहेगा, हो ही रही होंगी। मोहित श्रीवास्तव जी हैं, आलोक पांडे जी हैं, आप लोग कुछ कहना चाहेंगे? दिलशाद जी हैं, परीक्षित जी भी हैं, बताइए, फिर हम लोग क्लोज कर देंगे इसको सेशन को। क्लोजिंग कमेंट्स कुमार अब फिर बता दें फिर क्लोज करके।
भैया नहीं बहुत अच्छा रहा भैया, अगले संडे को हम लोग कंटेंट की क्लैरिटी को लेकर एक सेशन रख सकते हैं, तो जो FAQs हैं उसका जो निचोड़ है ना उसको थोड़ा सा हम लोग बात कर सकते हैं।
हाँ, उसको हम लोग प्लान कर लें। ये जो अभी वाला जो सेशन है इसके अंदर कुछ लोग प्रेजेंट करना चाह रहे हैं, उनकी तैयारी हम लोग बिफोर हैंड कराने का काम कर दें और वो भी कर लें, और ये जो FAQ वाला पार्ट है इसको एक बार किया गया है और इसको बार बार करने की जरूरत है। जो रिफ्रेशर 1 पार्ट 2 है वो बेसिकली यही काम है, तो रिफ्रेशर 1 पार्ट 2 जो है उसके अंदर जो बेसिक रियलिटीज हैं उसको ब्रीफली शेयर करने का काम है, प्लस उसमें जो FAQs हैं जो बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस जो उससे जुड़े रहते हैं उनको डिस्कस करने का काम है रिफ्रेशर 1 पार्ट 2 में। तो वो तो अच्छा रहेगा कि हम लोग उस काम को विधिवत कर लें। ये वाला जो सेशन है इसके अंदर जैसे आज का सेशन था इसमें कंटेंट बहुत ज्यादा था और टाइम बहुत कम था
जी भैया,
उसी तरह से FAQ वाला भी अगर हम लोग 1 घंटे वाले में करने की कोशिश करेंगे तो वो बहुत इतना आसान नहीं रहेगा। लगता है कि जो FAQs हैं जो अभी ऑलरेडी रिकॉर्डेड सेशंस में नहीं किए गए हैं कुछ अगर उसमें ऐड करना है तो उनको हम लोग ये मॉर्निंग सेशन में या यहाँ पे कर लें, उनको फिर जोड़ते जाए जो हमारे FAQ के रिकॉर्डिंग्स हैं उनको हम लोग को यूट्यूब के ऊपर डालना है ताकि सबसे उपलब्ध रहे वो। अभी वो वीडियो का जो कटिंग वाला पार्ट है वो नहीं हुआ है इसलिए वो नहीं डाले गए, तो जैसे हो जाएगा तो उसको डाल देना।
जी संडे मॉर्निंग कोई नया कंटेंट तो नहीं था तो अभी संडे वाले सेशन उसको रहने देते हैं, अगले दिन का कुछ प्लान कर लेते हैं फिर कि अगले संडे हम क्या
तो इसमें। हाँ वो आप लोग प्लान कर लो क्या करने वाले हैं। दिलशाद जी बताइए आप और परीक्षित जी कर रहे थे ना इसको।
अगले हफ्ते हमारे पास रविंद्र राउत जी की प्रेजेंटेशन के लिए बात हुई थी, पर अगर मुझे लगता है कि इसके ऊपर एक बार फिर से कुछ चर्चा हो जाएगी तो थोड़ा सा और एक क्लैरिटी हो जाएगी तब लोग प्रेजेंट करें तो और थोड़ा ठीक रहेगा।
नहीं, आपने कमिक वो किया हुआ तो रविंद्र रावत जी करें नेक्स्ट उसमें प्रेजेंट करें, उसके साथ में फिर इन रिस्पॉन्स उसमें एक एक पॉइंट को थोड़ा वो कर सकते हैं, हम लोग एक्सपांड कर सकते हैं।
ठीक है, तो अगले हफ्ते रविंद्र
रावत नेक्स्ट संडे है उसमें। ओके जी, ठीक रहेगा रविंद्र रावत जी?
ठीक है,
नहीं सर,
नमस्ते सर।
नमस्ते, नमस्ते।
ठीक, अभी
रोक बहुत सकते अच्छा सकते तो अभी क्लोज कर सकते हैं
जी। बहुत अच्छा, तो सभी को नमस्ते।
नमस्ते,
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 नमस्ते।